Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. And in this video today I've brought another exciting challenge, that's on the topic of gravitation, that is a missile to China. So what's the challenge? Let's get straight away into the challenge. That is, as a befitting reply for arrogance, Admiral Varada is entrusted with launching a projectile from somewhere in the Indian Ocean, latitude angle theta south to the symmetric latitude angle theta north, in the same longitudinal plane. What should be the minimum launch velocity of the projectile to accomplish the mission? Neglect air drag and the rotation of Earth. Radius of Earth is R and mass is M. So, to recap, we are throwing a projectile somewhere from here, that is latitude theta south, and then it is to land at latitude theta north, and it's in the same longitudinal plane. So this is the challenge. We want to find out the minimum velocity, and we have to neglect the air drag and the rotation of Earth. So you can take 5 to 10 minutes for trying out this problem, and then after that we'll see an elegant, a very quick solution of this problem using a trick. So you can pause the video and try it now. All right, now let's get into the solution. So before I get into the solution, I want to state some of the standard facts in gravitation that you learned in your normal course of IIT JEE preparation. That is, first fact is, for all projectiles or satellites, the center of Earth is one of the foci of the elliptical orbits. That's fact one. Second fact is that total energy of any projectile or satellite is given by E is equal to minus gmm by 2a. It's presented in almost all standard textbooks for IIT JEE. That is the total energy of the orbit. And then in this formula, you know that A is the semi-major axis of the trajectory. The third fact is that for an ellipse, the sum of distances from two foci is 2a. So this is a standard fact that you learned in your mathematics, in your coordinate geometry, when you learn about ellipse, that sum of distances from two foci for any point in ellipse is 2a. So now look at this expression carefully. So total energy is minus gmm by 2a. So that means what? Smaller the value of A, lesser is the value of E. Note that this is a negative expression. So we want the minimum possible value of the major axis so that the total energy is minimized. Why? Because from the surface of Earth, the potential energy is anyway fixed, and we want to minimize the kinetic energy. When you are minimizing the velocity, that means you are minimizing the kinetic energy. That means you want a minimum value of A. So for minimum velocity, we want an orbit with smallest possible total energy or smallest possible major axis, one and the same thing. So now we can easily do this problem just based on these three facts. Look at the geometry, and I'm sure you're going to love it. It's very beautiful. So here, this is our lovely Earth, and this is the point P where the projectile has to reach, or otherwise it's one and the same thing. You know that symmetric projectile, you can throw from south to north or north to south, so the projectile is symmetric. So let's say P is the point where the projectile lands. So you know that this is one of the foci, so that means what? Distance of P to the focus 1 is R, and now you want to minimize the total major axis, and you know that PF1 plus PF2, let's say F2 is some point on this FH, that is the symmetric line drawn, the bisector of the trajectory. So F2 is to be searched on the line F1H such that PF1 plus PF2 should be minimum, because that is your semi-major axis. So obviously, for smallest possible semi-major axis, the F2 must lie on the line F1H. So this is your required major axis. F1P, that is R, and PF2, that is R sine theta. So now with this information, now we can easily do some maths and get the final answer. So now it's breeze. So semi-major axis becomes, you know that 2A is R plus R sine theta, that is PF1 plus PF2, that is R into 1 plus sine theta. That is your not semi-major axis, it's supposed it's a major axis. So ignore this word semi, its major axis is this, okay? And now potential energy at P is minus gmm by R. Obviously, this is on the surface of Earth. So potential energy is minus gmm by R. That's self-explanatory. And the total energy of the orbit then becomes minus gmm upon 2a. That is R into 1 plus sine theta. So this is the total energy of the orbit. Now, kinetic energy should be what? Kinetic energy should be total energy minus the potential energy. So you can just subtract the potential energy from the total energy, and that you get kinetic energy is E minus U is equal to this is the expression that you get on simplification, and this should be equal to half mv square. Now you can cancel off m on both sides and solve for v, which will be our required answer. So if you solve for v, you get v is root 2 gm sine theta upon r times 1 plus sine theta. This is your final answer. So that was our challenge for this video. Hope all of you liked it. And if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel and like the video and give it a thumbs up, and please share it with all of your friends, whoever might find this video relevant for their preparation for IIT JEE or Olympiads. Thank you very much, and see you in the next video. All right.